Well, here we are again. Thank you for joining me. In this video, we're going to look at an advanced technique called the rotisserie, also known as off-axis turning. This technique, I just want everybody to know that it's something that I'm still working on. I would love to share all the knowledge that I have learned about this technique with you, but I'm not perfect at it. I still have a long way to go. So let's all try and improve together. At least we have a way of knowing how to practice at least. So the rotisserie has six ways of turning. So we've got our body going front to back, heading left and heading right. And then we have our body on the side, heading left or heading right. And then we have our body on the other side, heading left or heading right. Okay, so trying to get the footwork to go in conjunction with the upper body is challenging to work out which foot to move. So we're going to work through all of that. So this is going to be a bit of a lengthy introduction video, but hopefully you'll be able to fast forward to the bit that's meaningful for you and then put it into practice later when we put a song with it. So the rotisserie, why is it called a rotisserie? Because the idea is that you have the image of the spear of the barbecue chicken going right through your head, okay, through the top of your head. So the exercise that I've been given by the master, Alison Sandy, thank you so much. This is where I learned this technique from and this drill to use. So please make sure you follow all of his social media, Alison Sandy. He's taught me so much and given me so many ways to practice on my own. So I have him to thank for a lot. So the first time I ever asked him to teach me rotisserie, he said the first thing to do is to start with your hands up against a wall and pretend like there's a spear going from your hands into the wall and just try and shuffle yourself around, keeping that orientation the same. And this way as well. So just shuffling your feet, not worrying too much about stepping until you can get that feeling of the turning of the spear going through your head. So once you have that feel, the next thing is to go back to the footwork. So first ones we're going to work on, we got six different turning variations. So first one we're going to work on is just going up and down the line. So this is just simply half turns, keeping your feet underneath your hips for each half turn, making sure you transfer from one foot to the other, being clear about which foot your weight is on, not spending too much time with the weight evenly separated between both feet because it's going to be a traveling turn. So this is one, heading to the left or heading to the right. So there's already two footwork variations. Let's then put the upper body into that. So the key point that Alison taught me with this technique is to make sure that the upper body starts the movement, but the feet arrive first. Okay, so if we're to start down, the upper body starts to twist, trying to keep that spear running straight through from straight ahead of me. So the upper body starts to twist. I try and keep the crown of my head in that direction, but watch what happens with the foot. It gets there before my chest is directly to the ceiling. My upper body continues to go, trying to keep that spear through the top of my head, but foot arrives before the body does. And you do that same thing all the way down that line, and it's exactly the same in the other direction. Upper body goes, keeping that spear through the top of the head, foot arrives before the chest comes to the top. Upper body carries on, foot arrives before we get down. So that's what gives that really nice flow to this movement. Upper body, try and smooth it out. Foot arrives first, foot arrives first. Where is the contraction? So we want to try not to be bending anything at the waist here. It's a contraction forward, pushing that chest back. And then opening. Try and think about the chest going to the ceiling here. to counteract for the weight of your head, push your hips forward, making sure you're not stretching, not contracting through that lower back there. We don't want to have a curve there, so push your hips forward when your head is at the back. All right, so that's two done. Let's talk about the ones on the side. I find these ones harder than the ones up and down the line. So I'll take it to my right side, which will look like the left to you, but same both sides, it's okay. Actually, footwork first. So footwork, really just have to think about this as sort of like a simple turn. Which way am I turning? So if I'm turning to the right, then I need to pivot on my right. Pivot. When we start to add the upper body, what you can do is just do it in quarter turns, quarter, making sure if you're turning to the right, the weight's on the right. Now, if our head is tilted this way and we're turning to the left, we need to be pivoting on the left foot. So it'll be the same. Da, da. Again, take it in quarter turns to start off with, because it's really quite tricky to get your head to stay in the correct spot on these sideways ones. We'll just switch straight over to this side because it's exactly the same. If my head is over on the left and I'm turning to the left, I pivot on the left. If my head is on the left and I'm turning to the right, which will be heading up first, then I pivot on the right. All right. So let's talk about what was happening in the upper body there. So if we are tilted to the right, thinking about stretching up and over in these ribs, don't let the hips splay out. So we're thinking about up and over and the head relaxing. We have to think, okay, where is that spear coming out of the top of my head? That's the point out there that you need to keep your head at. So it's very helpful to go into the quarter turns first. Here, if you're contracted down, that spear is still there. As you go to the side, you're now going to be lifted up and over on your right side with the spear out there. As you go to the back, spear stays out the top, chest to the ceiling, hips pushed forward, and here, back to where we started. So this is why it's so important to practice this for a length of time. You need to try and get this feeling to your body of the quarter turns first before you can half turn it. Because the half turning here is fine, but these ones coming over the back is tricky. All right, so start with the quarter turn, then go up to the half turn. So that was turning to the right. Then if we turn to the left, remember your weight is going to have to transfer over to your left foot, and we're going to be heading quarter turn up, quarter turn side, quarter turn forward, quarter turn back where we started, then turn it into the half turn, half turn, half turn, half turn. So remembering to get that up and over feeling, chest to the ceiling, pelvis forward, the up and over feeling, and the contraction. So you're getting all of that as you go around, but the head stays in the same spot. Similarly, this side, exactly the same as what we did that side, okay? But all going to the other way. So that's how we get 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 different ways of doing rotisserie. Anything I didn't really talk about too much is using the floor, making sure your feet don't lift up, making sure you're pushing through the balls of your feet the whole time, making sure, as usual, you've got that posture with the pulling up through your psoas, making sure you're engaged in the core, making sure your legs are engaged, thighs turned out, and strong, soft legs. Let's give it a go with some music. Yay! Rotisserie, let's start with the footwork. I'm going to do the ones going up and down the line. So remembering to keep the feet under the hips for these ones. and just doing half turn, half turn. Step, half turn. Hold it here. Go back the other way. Step, half turn, half turn, half turn. Stop here. So let's add the upper body. Start with a contraction forward. We're going to go straight into half turns. And as much as I want to be with you. Chest to ceiling. I know. Forward. Go the other way. Remembering, upper body first, foot arrives first. Upper body goes, foot arrives. Upper body, foot. One more. Come up. Recover. Again, the other way. Contract. Upper body goes, keeping your head forward. Crown to the front. And come up. Let's try and smooth it out a little. Okay, let's try to the side. Stretch up and over. Remembering, we're going to start with quarter turns for our footwork, heading to the left, so turning to the back. Head is going to stay out to the side. Back. Side. Speed it up a little. Forward. Side. Back. Side. Forward. Side. Back. Half turns. Half. 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 Come up. Let's turn this way. We're going to be turning on your right foot now, so you're turning the other direction. So, quarter turn, quarter turn, quarter turn, head to the back, to the side, forward, side, smooth it out, half, 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 half. Let's try the other side. Stretch up and over. So let's start by pivoting on our right foot. So you'll be turning to the right. Quarter turn. Crown forward. To the side. To the back. To the side. Half turn it. Half. 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 Come up. Other direction. Onto your left foot. So you'll be turning to the left. Quarter turn. Quarter turn. Always keeping your head out this side. Half turn it. Half. 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 Upper body goes before the foot. Remember, foot arrives first. Come up. So we're going to choose one and try and smooth it out without doing that. Stop. Stop. I think I need like 6 songs to practice. One for each direction. One's not enough. I hope you got something out of that. Notice I didn't do any arms because we just need to focus on the core technique first. Arms can come later. Thank you.